Hello everybody, it's a me, a friendly porcupine, and what do I have for you today? It is the Mr. BUC 2.0. Yes, Mr. BUC has had an improvement. And if you're wondering what Mr. BUC actually stands for, it stands for Base Universal Character, and that's also how the way it is spelled. This BUC is different from the previous BUC review that I've done because this BUC is BUC 2.0. If you have not seen my previous video on the previous BUC version, Mr. BUC, here is video where you can check it out. This figure was sent to me by TFGeek. Yes, TFGeek, the awesome guy who actually designed this figure and made it Mega Construx compatible. And if you want to actually check out this Mr. BUC figure or show TFGeek some love, the link to his store will be in the description below, so you can actually check out some of the other stuff that TFGeek has done, such as the super cool Batman figure, the Twisted Metal Sweet Tooth, the Mrs. BUC, yeah, a Mrs. BUC. Anyways, this figure contains 21 pieces. I have actually counted. And before I begin with the entire review, some very important things that need to be mentioned. First of all, this figure is not designed for crazy, serious play. So you have to be very gentle as to make sure that you don't rip some of the parts, because this figure is 3D printed. It's amazing what a 3D printer can do. And number two, a tip from TFGeek. If you put this figure in hot water for roughly about like 15-20 seconds, it loosens up all of the molds, making it a lot more easier to assemble. Because when you get this figure, it all comes in a bag with pieces that are deassembled and other stuff, so you have to put it all together. Now, enough of the important information, let us begin with the review. To do this review proper justice, it is much more proper to introduce the older Mr. BUC figure and do comparisons to show exactly how this figure, the 2.0 version, was improved. First things first. The feet actually stick to studs without snapping, without any cracks, and they attach very easily. Let me show you. You can see right here, let me take off figure and attach them one more time. Boom, foot attached easily. Boom, foot attached easily. And they also come apart easily, which is a very good thing, as opposed to the previous Mr. BUC figure. See that? It attaches, but there is already a little tiny line of crack right there. Moving on to the next foot. I don't want to risk it, but you can already see that. Oh my goodness, that's a serious crack. And I don't want to break the previous Mr. version of Mr. BUC, so to be more gentle on that one, but that's essentially the entire thing. Very good improvement. However, there's still a problem with the knees. The knees, unfortunately, yeah, see this one? It snapped. They have a tendency to snap because this is just such a skinny, tender point. I know, it creates the aesthetics and that's really good, but you have to be very, very gentle with the knees and other stuff, because that's the part that snaps most often. This figure on this version also had a snapped knee right here. So you have to be gentle. And like I said, previous Mr. BUC version also had the snap knees. The snap knees. Okay, here it is right here. You can see, wait, this is previous Mr. BUC version. So you can see I super glued the knee, so you can actually still fix it. So yeah, this is a fixable problem. You can actually super glue it and it can make it work very nicely, but you have to be gentle. As opposed to this version, I've also noticed the knees rotate a bit better on this one. But another thing I've also noticed, with time these figures get better. This was the previous version and the knees were much more difficult to rotate, and now the knees are much more easier to rotate. So with time the mold does get better because all of the pieces get used to being stuck to each other. So yeah, that's the best way I can put it. As for the knees with the ball joint, of course they rotate. This part is a little bit slow. For this figure right here, it's still very stiff despite, that's another problem this figure has. The torso was very, very loose. Yeah, I'll get into that later, but yeah. This part, it rotates, it's still a little bit thick. As opposed to this figure, the knee just rotates. You see that thing on the ball joint? It rotates so nicely, this foot. And then this foot right here, it also rotates pretty nicely, but it's a little bit more stiffer. Yes, and like I said, you have to be very gentle, because you don't want this thing to fully rip. And of course, just like the previous Mr. Buck figure, the aesthetics with the hamstrings, the knees, you know, the shins, like, it all looks very excellent. And of course, these boots can actually rotate. Well, not the boots, because they are on ball joints, the feet. And the feet also have excellent, excellent detail. You can see the nails, the fingers and everything. It's very good. Now, improvement number two. The torso right here, which can rotate, of course, excellent detail, just as previous one. The torso is a bit tighter on this one, which is good improvement, as opposed to the previous one, which was so loose you can literally hang it upside down and it will fall off. But now, like I said, with time the mold gets thicker and tougher. So you see this one, this one was so loose. If you've seen my previous review, you know exactly what was the situation. But yeah, this one, it got a little bit tighter. This one, I've also noticed it's a lot tighter now. So yes, the torso has been improved. It's still a little bit loose to maybe someone's liking, but it is so much better than the previous version. And probably same with this one, the torso will get much more tighter and much more stronger with time. Now, as for the button winner part, I've also noticed that the button winner part, see, the previous one used to push out like crazy, which used to keep lifting up, which is what made the torso so loose. For this one with the button, ooh, chihuahua, yeah. It really, really ripped. So just for the time being, I think what might be best is if I just remove it, guys. It's a really bad rip. Yeah. Okay. So Mr. Buck is gonna be with one foot for now. So yeah. Anyways, improvement number three: the arms. The arms have been improved much better. So you can see right here, this arm right here already had a rip just by pushing this in. As opposed to these arms right here, there is no rip. And these hands can actually rotate without feeling like it would rip. Same how just with this hand, it feels a little bit too tight. And it feels like this one can rip a bit more. So you have to be gentle, and of course, with time, the figure will get better. Chico, man, that thing is really annoying. Good news, comrades! I've actually fixed the problem with super glue. So, yes, super glue to the rescue, actually fixed the problem, and now Leggy can actually articulate. Yes, this is the second day of reviewing this set. You still have to be very, very, very gentle. But can actually rotate it now. Yes, yes, this is the way it's actually supposed to work. Unfortunately, just these parts are just so skinny, they really tend to rip very often. But thankfully, yeah, super glue actually fixed the problem, and now I can actually use the figure. Like, yes, thank God for super glue. Let's move on up to the hands. So this is how the hands are designed, very similar to the previous one, but there are improvements, of course. So, we can see right here, the hand actually goes in way much more nicer without snapping. See that right there? When you tried to push in this hand, it was a little bit too tight, so it snapped. Thankfully here, there has been no snapping. This hand right here is like perfect. Ugh. This one right here, it's very good. It rotates very well and it easily removes. Boom. And of course, with these hands, of course, you can get a weapon and actually attach it to the figure. And there you go, for demonstration, just like with previous one, it actually rotates so the finger can actually go into the slide. So yes, that feature is still working very well. And of course, with these hands, you get the rotation that you can rotate up and down with. Fortunately, this hand's a little bit tight, but it does work. Just like with the regular Mega Construx figures, you can rotate these hands up and down, rotate them like this. Of course, be careful the way you rotate, because this is how I actually ripped one of them last time, with just the constant movement. One of these arms have been ripped and I already super glued them. So you have to be very, very gentle with how you articulate these figures. So be very gentle, boom, and it shouldn't be a problem. As for this hand right here, it's a little bit tight, but it does work. So unfortunately with this hand, you see, this hand much more in, this hand much more out. So yeah, that's a bit of a bummer, but I don't want to push it in too much because I'm too scared of it ripping. So I'm just going to leave it like this for right now. But so far the figure does work better. And as for the torso, it is a bit tighter. But what I've noticed is from this previous figure, the torso gets much more tighter onto the figure with time. So if you give it time, the torso actually attaches pretty well. Whoop. Yeah, you see right here, torso not fall off on both of them. With the type of material, it will get much more tighter with time. Anyways, another big difference you might have noticed is of course the heads. This head has been improved. It's much more easier to move, much more softer. Of course, you can move up and down. You're wondering what all of those little flakes are? Well, that's what happens when you put it in hot water. It gets a little bit flaky, but that's what makes it a lot more softer, and that's what makes it a lot more easier to attach. Though, you have to be careful when you put in hot water, because hot water does make the material softer, meaning it's more likely to rip if you're not very gentle. But it's also more likely to rip if it's hard, so you have to get it just right to make sure, which is why 15-20 seconds is more than enough for the hot water to do its trick. Anyways, of course, with this head movement, it's a little bit tight, but of course it still rotates. Now, as for the head size, it's more of an aesthetic thing. You might like the head to be smaller, you might like the head to be bigger. To me, it looks a little bit weird that the head is a bit smaller since I'm so used to the Mega Construx size of head molds, but then again, you have to remember, human bodies to proportion of head are usually not that humongous like Mega Construx. So this figure clearly a lot more accurate, and it's going to get time to get used to this smaller head mold. But if the head mold is still too small, if you actually have the female BUC figure, yes, Mrs. BUC, this is the actual figure I'm going to review after this review. Here's a hair mold that you can take on. If you take this hair mold and actually slide it onto the newer version of Mr. BUC, which is also compatible with the Mrs. BUC haircuts, boom, there you go. You can have this type of haircut, which kind of looks like the Karen haircut. Okay, anyways, comrades, yes. And the thing is, you see, now it doesn't look that much smaller. So if the smallness is too problem, put on wig or put on hair or Karen haircut, and there you go, it's done. And of course, as the back, the details are excellent. Of course, you can attach backpack over there. Let's actually test it out and not just talk about it. All right, Mr. BUC, are you ready? Boom. And it works perfectly fine. I love it. I love it, TFGeek. I love it what you've done with these figures. Of course, you slide it off and boom. Okay, Mr. BUC, it is time to meet your doom in the final judgment. For the aesthetics, I give this set a 10 out of 10. Epic detail, same as last time. For the playability, I give this set an 8 out of 10. Overall, the playability is much better than the previous BUC version. There's been lots of improvements, but some improvements still need to be made. For the value, I give this set an 8 out of 10. It's a one-of-a-kind figure that you can only get from TFGeek with the crazy amount of articulation. So, want the super crazy detail? Figure, this is the only way to do it, because Mega Construx probably not going to do a figure this detailed. And last but not least, for the build, well, since there really isn't much of a build in the set, it's more of a figure, I'm going to consider the build as all of the pieces that go in together, because you technically do have to build the figure when you get it out of the box. For the build, I'm mainly judging the quality. And the quality on this figure is much higher than the previous Mr. BUC figure. And I expect it to get much better with time, just like how it got better with the Mr. BUC 1.0, the previous version. So if you give it time, Mr. BUC 2.0 will probably be much more better and much more easier to articulate. Like I said, when the pieces are all assembled and the figure stays like that, the pieces get more used to being stuck to each other. And of course, there is still work to be done with some of the parts, of course, with the quality, but it is much, much, much an improvement compared to the previous Mr. Buck. And that brings us to the final score, which I give an 8.5 out of 10. It's a B. Well, my comrades, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you wanted to actually get this figure for yourself, link is in the description below to TFGeek store. And please show that guy some love, cause what he's doing here is amazing. And my comrades, if you enjoyed this review, be sure to give it a like. And if you want to see more reviews, such as the Mrs. Buck figure, hit subscribe and I'll catch you in the next video, possibly when Mrs. Buck is actually reviewed. Mrs. Buck, 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 dun, 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 Mrs. Buck, Buck, Buck. Mrs. Buck has been terminated. Oh no, Mr. Buck 2.0 has been terminated by tan 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 tan. Ah, it's so stupid, it's not even funny.